Hello everybody, just a small update. I want to show you the things I'm working on at the moment, which are mostly map related, and just want to start a campaign as Frankish Empire, Eastern Frankish Empire, because I'm currently rework a lot of minor stuff and try to fix some small bugs in the UI. And the last remaining source for crashes, which is one kind of bug. It's the last kind of bug, I think, is this crash the desktop, which can be fixed if you reload the game 2 or 3 turns and replay. Not the best solution, but with this solution I can run up to 200 turns and more per campaign. Okay, these are the normal options at the beginning. Generals are important, you may know it. The script should prevent stack spam from the player. Because it forces the player to have at least one general in every settlement. From the rebels, yes, I want them appear on the map. Because now I can show you the small watchtowers over the map. And as you can see, my empire is very underdeveloped, but very visible. With the script Stronger Rebels, you are forced to clean up all these raiders and stacks, invaders, and whatsoever.
Our elders will honor me when I defeat you.
This is a good introduction, I think, also for the army, and to iron out your generals and to start the campaign, the Eastern Frankish Empire. For every player who played with them at the last release, there are typical movements and typical starting moves that I play always, well, at least mostly. First thing is I create.
Ja, noble Kaiser. We shall continue tomorrow, mein Kaiser. For the right.
And
honor to lead the right. An honor, Kaiser.
A decent half stack with two generals.
Hail,
one
mein
family
Kaiser.
Carolingian. And a normal general without any connection.
An
to
honor,
your family
Kaiser.
Tree. And my goal is firstly to conquer Kreinborg. Of course, it's also a mark, Ostmark, but it's an important city. This settlement is the first way of protection against the Croatians, which will get stronger after some time and mostly attack you. And Kreinburg is a good buffer and a good source for also some local troops, like this very effective raiders.
Hail mein Kaiser.
With my stronger rebels, there's also a small stack, a half stack I think is it, which is lurking in the woods. And
for
next
the
turn,
Reich.
If I attack Kreinburg, these rebels will immediately attack me. And together with the garrison, which is a decent amount of troops, I'm forced to play a 2-to-1 battle, and it's a hard one. Normally this is also a hard nut. If you attack Kreinborg, they sally out because they think they are strong enough to fight back, which they are, because they have decent troops. Swordmen, very good bowmen, also good for melee. The Jabbermen are very effective against armor and against normal troops, they are basically good spearmen with javelins and effective against armor. My troops are somewhat limited. My spearmen can hold the line, but not for much. These are very decent troops. They are basically a better version of these and are also effective against armor. My cavalry is superior. This is two bodyguards, but they are mostly stuck. And with this other reinforcement, it's very tricky to win this battle. But you may have success, and you are cleaned this area and conquer a settlement. You also get an auto garrison if you accept the Grandsmark script. But this script spawns at turn 2 or 3. I don't know for sure. I think 2. Yeah. So, enough talk. Right, you notice this cluster of Hungarian raiders, which are very much annoying. They will butcher you with a normal army. You need cavalry to fight them back. And my cavalry is somewhat spread out. And my first goal is to create at least a full stack and kill all these small
elders will honor because over time if you
let them behave like they do, they create devastation and will cost you a good amount of money. Also, I don't want them in my borders. I want to iron out my my full stack. I clean up these armies, and then mostly I went for these two settlements, create the Moravian mark, or if I'm in a rush, I try to conquer the Pannonian mark, which is basically this area here, which are three or four settlements with Kreinburg. But it's hard because you get in contact with the Croatians, sometimes with the Serbs and with the Bulgarians. But you have also your ally, your Moravian Empire on your border, which will take care of these regions after some time. Okay. So, what have we done? You will notice I'm in the red already. But that's not for long. Of course, you have plenty of options to one part reduce your armies or put them into forts or minor cities and learn the free upkeep.
Command me.
This we will do for the most part. Create
Kaiser.
And this is more always the first turn
Kaiser.
Boring stuff.
Ja, mein Kaiser! Ja! Ja, will!
It's also good cavalry. I will use him as a reinforcement.
Ja, mein Kaiser!
Game.
March!
Could do something here.
Ja, will! Kaiser! Ja! Orders, Kaiser!
Also use most of these expensive units, like this one.
Moment. Orders, march!
Great leader.
This one need to go.
Today's journey is over.
We are free upkeep already. Okay, so we have Bamberg, which also need
your will! Orders, Kaiser! Ja, Kaiser! Today's march
hopefully
ends here, Kaiser! Kaiser! Ja, mein Kaiser! Forward! Today's journey is over!
Which is in Hotsburg. There's two authority, which isn't that much, but
ja, will.
To
ja, mein Kaiser.
Basically give you some
ja, will.
Some kind of.
Ja, Kaiser! Today's march ends here, Kaiser!
I want to bring them up with my army in Regensburg. They have decent troops here, but I need more. And this I will do. I create every unit possible. It's the first turn, they will respawn at 40 turns, but put them in the queue simply to get some turns. Get some turns earlier, so. Let's book.
Orders, Kaiser! Kaiser! March! We make camp here!
Yes, Alpine cities are underdeveloped.
Your will! Orders, Kaiser!
This one. I believe so.
Your will! Your Kaiser!
Kind of okay.
Orders, Kaiser!
I like this.
Your will!
Explorators. Also Frankfurt. I think Frankfurt is the last settlement.
Kaiser! Your will! Ja! Today's march ends here, Kaiser!
I think I've got some more. Take a quick look.
An honor, Kaiser! Hail an honor, holy Kaiser! Hail mein an honor, Kaiser! Hail mein Kaiser! For the Reich, holy Kaiser! For the Reich! An honor, for the Reich! An honor, holy Kaiser! Hail, mein Kaiser!
Ja, mein Kaiser!
Okay.
Your will!
In earlier versions, there were some troops in course, but the IE can't handle them and I didn't put them out. Not necessary for anything. You need a fleet. You can buy a fleet, but they are stuck forever on the island. Can't conquer anything. Yeah. So we have our movements. As you can see, we are in the depth, but not for long. Because the next step is to build up my first tier of garrison of Tormod. Pay attention for my money because I don't want to lose my mercenaries. My mercenaries are units like the ROR, like the Moravians,
ja, mein Kaiser.
Like the very good the Slavic units. And if I run into the red, I will lose them. So we have some ready. Next will be create a recruit diplomat to get some trade deals and some map information. Maybe earn some money. And that's basically the thing for the first turn. Let's save. Yes, yes. Okay. Yeah, you will notice these are all my turns. I save them with every number. Okay. So let's end the turn. Maybe I will be attacked. In Kreinburg, but I think they are lurking. You will also notice all these hidden rebel stacks, which I enabled with the first turn script. Stronger rebels, they will come out from their hiding and move to the watchtowers, where you can easily spot them after some turns. If they don't find a watchtower, they will stay where they are.
Our elders will honor me when I defeat you.
Orders, Kaiser.
For the most part.
March. Today's journey is over. Ja, mein Kaiser.
So.
Forward.
Your
will.
deployed.
Ja, Kaiser.
Today's journey is over. Units, aggressive.
Ja, mein Kaiser. Forward. We make camp here.
Get in.
Ja, will. Kaiser. Ja, Kaiser.
We have a minimal amount of money, which and is because of our recruitment.
Resting here, Kaiser.
Yes. Our second unit of Militis Descensi, which is our best infantry unit. We definitely need this unit to do anything. Besides these cavalry stacks. But
when
they are combined, this half stack is a decent force, and I will be able to fight back these rebels.
Our elders will honor me when I defeat you.
Just let me see.
Mein Kaiser.
Already moved. Settlement's okay. Want to see where
your
they are here.
Forward.
Sometimes
an honor, Kaiser.
Well, Kaiser. I forget them to move.
Your will. Orders, Kaiser. Hail, mein Kaiser.
Most important. So, we are positive. We are at second turn. Next turn, there will be the introduction for the scripts. And also,
an honor, Kaiser. We will conquer with honor, Kaiser. Laying siege, holy Kaiser.
Iron Crown script is following.
We have them besieged, mein Kaiser.
Next turn. Right, that's basically the first two turns. Kind of sort of my empire. Lay the first actions to hands of my generals. I will definitely see here at least a sally out from the garrison or an attack from these hidden rebels. There's also a full stack in this area, which mostly leave the woods. They are hidden here in this area. There's also a second stack in this area. Yeah, here we can see this one, this one.
Let the war god decide who shall live.
There's also one hidden in the trees in this area, and I think here are also one or two stacks. Italy is a problem of its own because we need to develop this Verona foothold or stronghold and try to sneak up some rebel territories in this area. They are quite rich and you can conquer for the most part Bologna, which forces the Venice Republic to go south. And if they go south, this area, Pisa and Genoa, Mailand, they will be rebel stacks for some time. But you have time, you can conquer them. The Papal States won't be too aggressive. The Lombards need time to consolidate, and they need at least 40-50 turns to show up. And if they show up and you own Bologna and Pisa, you're quite secure in northern Italy. If they decide to attack you, you have a problem, but Italy has good troops. Very good local units. Yeah. Also here I will have my Croatian recruitment, my Moravian recruitment, and another new script that will show up after some time are the Viking raids in the Moselle and Rhine area, which have a historical source, and you basically will face a big amount of Viking rebels which conquer or try to conquer Frankfurt and later Babenberg. those settlements, for the most part, you can't hold. You can try to reconquer with this deck, but this definitely need time. And you, well, for the most part, lose Frankfurt and Babenberg. Other option is you can pay them 4,000 mana per year, which is a lot. And if you remember, 4,000 is the upkeep for a full stack, at least for two turns. So I won't pay them, I will lose the settlement, but I will pay my armies and reconquer and use my armies to full effectiveness.
Kaiser!
Okay. Hope you have some enlightenment and some interest in playing the Eastern Frankish Empire. For my part, it's one of my favorite factions because they are quite diverse, they have a good roster, a kind of limited roster, but you have sources for heavy infantry, for good heavy cavalry, for light cavalry, limited options for archers, limited skirmishers, but all around a very cavalry and heavy infantry focused nation, which is also quite developed. If you play some minor city battles, you will notice that all these battle maps are different. There's a variety of four different battle maps, and I'm not sure which one will have which minor city will have the settlement. Or there's also a keep inside the vanilla keep. But maybe you will find out for yourself. So have a nice day. Bye.